way.
So today we are here for our coffee chat with Miss Valerie, one of our BDS Studios teachers. She's been with us. Miss Valerie, how long have you been with us?
Maybe like, maybe 5 years now.
Wow, it's been that long.
Time
goes by so fast. So before we started recording, we were talking about today would have been the day we have our annual spring concert. That's why I have my spring concert shirt on in memory. In memory of spring concert. And you said you were getting pictures all week?
Yes. Years past.
Of years past. So what was your favorite year so far?
I don't have favorite years.
I have a favorite everything. Everything is my favorite, but you know.
Until the next one comes.
Until the next one comes, then that's my favorite, yes. So, yeah, I'm excited. And we have our theme for next year. Should we share our theme for 2020?
I don't think they can handle it yet.
They can't handle it yet? It'll be news when it comes up. So
yes, it will.
We'll save it. Miss Valerie, where's your tea? I know you don't drink coffee. Where's your tea?
We kind of got stuck. I was trying to get ready.
So. I got to get cute or have coffee.
And I have it here. I'm just not drinking it.
That's fine. So let's get this started. Miss Valerie, would you mind telling everyone a little bit about yourself, like your dance training and... I know, just a little bit.
How long? It's been a long time. Because I started at 5, but I started with just tap. And I think I did just tap for maybe 2 years. And then I started with ballet. And then once you start with ballet, it gets totally involved because after a while, you start taking more and more ballet classes. And then you start taking jazz, and then you start taking modern, along with adding more ballet classes.
Yes. Now you trained. You aren't originally from down here. Where are you originally from?
I am originally from New York, so I trained at a studio in the Bronx. Then I went to the High School of Performing Arts. I also trained at Alvin Ailey. I trained with Henry Letang for tap. I trained at Harkness. You know, you bounce around from studio to studio, take this class when somebody's gonna be there, take that class when somebody's gonna be there. But I was a ballet major in high school. I was a ballet major, in college, City College.
Went to City College in New York?
Yep.
So if dance is different when you go to New York.
Yes, because we didn't have to wait for our parents to pick us up from home and take us to class. We got on the bus and we went to class. So right out of school, I'm on the bus and I'm going to class.
How old were you when you
went to class? Probably middle school.
Oh, wow. Well,
you say middle school, junior high school.
You can't do that now. Very out here. Okay.
Well, of course you can. Well,
because I had my first going... I have family in New York, so we would do what I call the family exchange every season. So I would have to go
send children
to New York or the Bahamas during winter, and then my cousins from New York or the Bahamas would come to Miami during the summer, and so it was like the family exchange type thing. And then of course as I got older, like you said, you bounce around from studio to studio. Taking classes or the summer intensive, the more
advanced you become.
Advanced classes, yes. And you go to these major companies like Harkness or Ailey. And I think I was 15, 16 the first time I went. And it was just, it was different.
Well, it's different coming from a neighborhood studio and then going to Manhattan to a studio to take class. Shock. Oh, huge rooms. Oh, I loved Harkness. They had these huge rooms with these high ceilings.
And it was like a dance for days. Like,
it was just a gorgeous place to be.
Okay. And then you ended up here and you were teaching.
I was teaching at the Edwin Holland School of Dance. And guess who I had in one of my classes?
Now, Ms. Valerie, you won't believe this though. So, you know, you always have those teachers that you just like, oh, I think you were my first, like, not Mr. Ed, Miss Gail teacher. And I really, you know, you even today, hey, Miss Seppi. Miss Seppi is here, and it sounds like Mr. Trey as well. I remember you in your leotard, in your high heel tap shoes, and it was like, ooh, I'm gonna look like that one day. I'm gonna be that one day. You know, that was you were the first teacher to make me be like, this is what I'm gonna do. Like, I don't think I ever told you that. And then hey, Miss Effie. Miss Effie's coming in here with us. Oh, she said she's gonna sit on the side. You know what? Show your face. Hey. Mr. Trey didn't show his face. Mr. Trey is running out of town, so we won't. But tell us more about your teaching journey. What made you decide to teach?
Well, I was at the studio and our teacher was running late. So of course the studio owner's mother was at the reception desk. So she comes in and asks me, can you just go in there and get them started and have them do something until Vicky gets here? It's like, okay.
And this is why you were still in New York, right?
Yes, was I in high school yet? I may have been maybe a freshman in high school.
Wow.
So I started the class and then Vicky comes in and she doesn't stop the class. She just lets me go. And I'm like, you wanna come on in here? But she just lets me go. So after that, she's like, okay, I see you, you know, you've got some things. And then I would kind of fill in. And then one year she asked me to teach for her. So that's how I started teaching.
Never since.
There, and then maybe junior year, my other ballet teacher was at a camp summer, as an arts camp during summers. And she asked me to be her assistant. So I taught at camp during summers for tap. And just been teaching ever since. Had a little break with the kids, but.
And your what? Say that again.
Had a little break after I had two babies.
No babies. They're not babies anymore.
No, they are not.
Tell us about being a mom and managing that. And
yeah, no, I couldn't teach him because I had a full-time job and I had, they're 23 months apart.
You were pregnant when you...
I was pregnant with both. Yes, because Hiram... After I had the first one, I kept teaching. Through my second pregnancy, I kept teaching. But when I had the two little ones together and working full time, that didn't work. So I had to wait a while.
Okay, so here's my really deep question. You ready? Uh-oh. Why dance?
Why not dance? Because I am a dancer. This is who I am. This is what I do. And once you start and you love it and you're into it and it just kind of takes over and becomes your life. So I combine my love of dance with my love of children. And that way I'm extremely happy doing what I do.
I like that. So, and when it comes to like this, your students, what do you consider, what do you consider success? What does success look like?
Success is constant growth. Success is not giving up. Success is being determined no matter how hard it looks, no matter how hard it feels when you first start, to keep going until you get it.
And do you think that kind of translates, like that's why dancers are always very meticulous in life, like you're so meticulous
with in everything.
Focus, like, okay, it kind of spills over.
Yes, it gives you that spirit of determination. No, nothing's going to stop me. This is what I want. So yes, I've got to study to get what I want. Otherwise, it doesn't really mean much.
And so is that like the main thing you hope that the students gain from classes, or what is it that you like? Do we dream of them all becoming professional dancers and starring on Broadway and getting free tickets and sitting in the front row while they're with dancing in Harlem? Oh, that's just my dream. I'm sorry.
That would be the icing on the cake. Yes, can I have that? But I dream of them being stable human beings, emotionally fit, physically fit. I want every one of them to know their bodies. You have to know your own body. You can't let doctors tell you everything. And if you don't know, then you're taking their word and they could be wrong.
That's true. And even like daily life, you know, there's so many different images and things going on. Learning, I don't think we talk to kids about their bodies enough and what to expect as they grow, or how to be, what's the word? How to be comfortable in their own skin and empowered and have agency. That's the word I'm looking for, agency in their own body, so that, you know, no one else can kind of tell them how they should move or how they should react or take advantage of who they are. I agree with that. That's a big deal. Like being emotionally stable and physically stable. I do hope that they all gain that. Yes. Okay. And
know who you are.
Knowing who you are. How do we get them there? Like, what are some of the things you do in your class, or what are some of the things I can do in my class to better, how can I be a better
person? I like to pay attention to their strengths. And then when there's a weakness, they can apply what they use in those strengths to that weakness to make it become a strength as well. Wow.
And who are your ideal students?
My ideal students are dressed, ready ahead of class. They have come in, they have warmed up. When the door opens, they're ready to walk in and ready to work. They pay attention, they listen, they watch, and they do.
Listen, watch, do. I'm gonna write that down. I like that. Write that down. Listen, watch, do. I like that. Because a lot of it is, I remember being in college and, you know, you join sororities and they stroll and stuff and everything. And, you know, everyone be like, come, let me teach you a stroll. I'm like, no, don't teach me. Do it. Like, you do it and I can watch you and I'll pick it up. Like, you
follow.
Know, from just watching instead of constantly like, okay, and 5, 6, and you do this. Like, yeah. It actually wrecks my nerves. I just do it and I'll watch and I'll pick it up. Yeah, I think that's a big thing with dance. Like you learn it by doing it, but you also, like, your eyes are more keen to things that's going on.
Yes. And you've got to watch those little details.
Yes, you pick them up, yeah. Okay. So Ms. Valerie, anything else you want to tell us? We have a couple of parents on. You guys can turn on your cameras or unmute yourselves if you would like. And if you have any questions for Ms. Valerie. No? No questions for Ms. Valerie? have a question for you, Miss Valerie.
Miss Sophie, writing questions.
We went through this a lot faster than I expected today. You have any questions for me? What are you most looking forward to?
Mm. Oh, please let me back into class.
please, I need to get it slow.
Yes, face to face, where I can see and physically correct.
I think that sometimes, especially with the little girls, like, I just want to be able to reach out and put my hands in the right way, turn your foot the wrong way.
Hold your arm up.
Arms go down here. What about, tell me some of your ideas as far as, like this year coming up, classes and performances, things that you would like to see the studio do more of, less of, incorporate, add.
I am that technique person. So let's get that technique down where it becomes habit, where it becomes ingrained and born, so that when you start to work on your dances, you're not correcting technique, you're correcting performance.
But what exactly does that mean? Because, you know, I'm a parent, I drop my kid off, and I just expect you to teach them to dance. I don't understand. Like, they're with you for hours. Don't you just teach them to dance so that it's perfect when they get on stage? Isn't that like what?
That is what we do. But within that, every step has certain actions within it. So a plié is not just a plié. A plié is a bending of the knees with your back straight, legs turned out, heads up. And you have to think of all those little things to do that one thing.
Right.
So a tendu is not just stick your foot out there and point your foot. A tendu is sliding of the foot, articulating it all the way through the toes, stretching the leg, bringing those toes back in to your position. And you have to think of all of that while you're doing a tendu. Don't just plop your foot out there.
Right. It's the intention behind it.
It's the way you do a step. It's the way you do a movement.
I always like to think of class, or at least the way we do things at the studio, at BDS Studios, is it's like language arts. You know, you learn the words, you know, you learn the steps, plie, tendu, you learn the letters. You learn letters. Yeah. Come together, you make words, you take the good morning, Miss Christine. You take the words, you put them into sentences, you put them into, you know, paragraphs, and then you have essays, and you know, so that's all the work you have to do to get to the dance on stage. Like
one time. Yes, everything is a building block. Everything is
a building block. Yes. Miss Christine, how are you? Miss Christine, do you want to access anything? You can unmute yourself. It's okay.
I have a question.
Oh, Miss Seffi has a question while we
Miss Valerie, what is one way? It's one thing to learn a dance, but how can I make the audience feel that same emotion or feel what the dance is supposed to be portraying? Because I think when I was growing up, dance was like a storytelling through my motions.
You said it.
Yeah.
Through your emotions. They're not just, you don't get up on stage and just do steps. You've got your music. And as we choreograph, we're choreographing to that music. So it's making us feel something, making us want to do something. And we have to portray that to the children so that they will feel and do the same thing.
Yeah, I like that. Good question, Ms. Stephanie. I think Ms. Christine has herself unmuted. Go ahead, Ms. Christine.
Oh, just wanted to say good morning.
Good morning. For being with us today. So excited.
Yeah, the discussion with Ms. Valerie today, I wish more students was on to listen to what she had to say. But it was beautiful. It was nice. I enjoyed it.
Thank you. Yeah. I'll be sure to post the replay. I know Saturday mornings still a little bit hectic. Everyone's trying to, especially now, this is the first weekend of summer. So I get for getting outside. You know, it's been a while since we've been out, most of us. So. Or trying to recoup. Yes.
Yeah, you're doing a good job. Keep up the good work.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We also have Miss Francis. Is that Miss Francis or is that Zaria? Who's there?
Good morning. It's both of us. I'm good. Zaria has a question.
Go ahead, Zaria.
You wanna say it? Go ahead.
How does it feel to be on stage and everybody has learned new things?
She wants to know for Ms. Valerie, how does it feel to be on stage and dancing or?
Yes.
Yes, dancing.
That is the penultimate feeling to be on stage after you've put in all that work and training and rehearsing and practicing and going over and over and over. Now you get to show everybody what it is that you do, how well you do it, and you want to be at your top, your best. Every time, I don't care if you do this same show 50 times, every time you do it, it needs to be your best.
Oh, okay. Thank you for telling me, because I want to be a professional dancer when I grow up.
Yes. Okay. So I'll remember that.
You told your classmates that you were a ballerina, right?
Yes.
Yes, because they saw how flexible you were on the sit and reach test?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, you will always be better at PE than anybody.
Okay, you guys. Well, ooh, I know. Miss Valerie, I'm gonna put you on the spot. Give me
again.
More on the spot. I have you, so I get to do it. All right, let's see. So, just really quick, it's really not that complicated.
What I want us to do more of, now that I'm thinking about it, I want us to do more an actual ballet.
Ooh, like.
Like Swan Lake.
I was thinking, you know what's really been on my, I really would love to do a Firebird or Kyoto or, yeah. Or Swan
Lake. Yeah, a full ballet.
I would love to. I think that's something we can do like one summer or one spring or I don't know.
One spring.
I like that. Yes. What's your favorite ballet, Miss Valerie?
Not a favorite. Jewels, of course, Swan Lake, because I dance Swan Lake.
the older girls, did I do with the younger? No, the older girls, this like January through March classes, I had them doing the emeralds, the emerald section of Jewels. They actually picked it up pretty good. It's funny because every time I'm like, oh, we're going to do a ballet and I want you guys to watch it first. And they're all like, oh. And then realizing that I have to make them watch it with me. Like we have to sit down and watch it together. And then they get so excited and they're all into the story. And I'm like, I wouldn't tell you to do something that was boring. It's not boring. You've seen it, it sounds out of the way. That was two summers ago. We did we did the Bluebird variation from Sleeping Beauty. I always say Cinderella, Sleeping Beauty. And they would not, I mean, we were halfway through summer. They would not watch Sleeping Beauty, would not watch it. So finally one class, we just sat down and we watched it. And, you know, I didn't tell them the story. I didn't give them a synopsis. I let them watch it. Of course, they're engaged and they're talking about it the whole time. And then they're like, that's what we're learning right then. That's what, oh, okay. You know, this whole understanding. And I wish that we could do more ballets. I also wish that, you know, we could take our students more more performances. I think what we do is great. And then it all clicks together when they actually get to see it in another way besides what they see on television or what they know from school.
Right, and speak to the dancers after they perform.
And when they get to speak with the dancers after the performance, Dance Theater Problem is coming in September over here at Mark Cultural Center.
September
before Miss Seffi's birthday, like the 13th or something. So that'll be a good show for everyone to see. Okay, you ready, Miss Valerie? These are my questions. Uh-huh. I'll let you guys go.
Sure.
So just a quick this or that. You ready? So vacation or staycation?
Vacation.
Netflix or Hulu?
Netflix.
Like, I think Netflix. Night or morning?
Depends on for what.
No, you just have to pick night or morning.
Morning.
Early bird or night owl? That's what I should say.
Night owl.
Rich and famous or rich and unknown?
Well, if you're gonna be rich, you might as well be famous. Why be unknown?
Okay, passenger or driver?
Driver.
Art museum or history museum?
Art.
Car or bike?
Car.
Coffee or tea?
Tea.
City or countryside?
City.
Okay. Wine or beer? I don't know.
Wine.
And last but not least, ballet or tap?
Nope. I was a ballet major because there was no tap major.
But
I started with tap. Yeah. I love ballet, but yeah, no, can't choose one of those.
I say it's funny because once you tap, it's kind of like I need it somewhere in my life, somewhere. You know, I go to.
And tap is more of what our bodies are used to doing. I know we have to work on our feet and articulate, but that ballet is like kind of the rigid discipline.
Yeah.
Tap, you can do different things with your arms and doesn't matter.
Yeah. So Ms. Valerie, thank you so much for being with us today. Thank you, Ms. Holmes and Ms. Francis for being with us. I will post the replay. We have next week, we have our coffee talk with some of our volunteers and our sponsors. I hope everyone can make it. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out inside the virtual studio. I look forward to seeing everyone soon, almost July. And I'll be sure to post this. Yeah. Thank you so much, everyone. Bye.
Bye.
Have a good weekend. Bye.
You too.